just one night. I'm ready to go right now. I'm ready to go right now.
What's up, YouTube? Your man Icon the Barber here with another phenomenal tutorial for your eye. We already started in the cut. Here I am smoothing down the canvas, getting ready to perform an artwork. This piece would be what I call the faded leaf. My client Joy brought a picture in that she wanted me to duplicate in her head, and me being me, I'm not gonna turn down a good challenge. So as we get started, here I am, I'm cutting down the platform, removing all the bulk, going against the grain with a number two guard. Clients have to understand the importance of coming with a clean platform for the barber to work with. There's nothing worse than having a hair full of dandruff, dirt, just anything that's gonna fight and make the barber work more to get his imagination onto that canvas. Now that we have our canvas before us, let's get started with the design. With my Andy's GTX trimmer outliner, this outliner is modified with a ceramic blade. You gotta keep in mind that as you're doing designs, the more time you spend with the clipper running on the client's head, you have the more potential for the blade to heat up. Having a ceramic blade on your clipper will allow you to work a little longer without any discomfort to the customer. As I make my strokes, notice how I feather off from the head instead of digging in. And I'm using both ends of the clippers, never in the middle. You leave with one end, then you leave with the other. This will help you get fine tapered lines that will lift off the way that you need them to. The client is showing me a picture. So as I'm looking, I have to quickly move with the trimmer in order to get the desired design onto the canvas. This is just a sketch. Every barber is an artist in some form, way, or fashion. Observe how a real sharp clipper just slices and melts the hair away. These clippers are modified by yours truly, Icon the Barber. I make sure all my clippers and trimmers are up to par in order to perform the tasks that I want to perform on the client. A lot of people state, man, you're really good with this. Where you've been hiding this talent? It's not that we hide the talent, it's that we know what our talent is worth. And a lot of customers don't like to pay what it's worth. We take pride, we take joy in what we do. Every time you leave the barbershop, our name is on that work of art. And if it's under par or subpar, that just doesn't look good on the shop and your name gets dragged. And now with my number one guard open halfway up, I'm gonna start around the bottom. The bases and foundation for my fade, I'm gonna be blending up into the volume that she has on top. And now I have my number two guard on. I'm gonna hit that second line. Number two guard is closed. And you notice the further that I move up the head, the more I'm gonna open up that guard. And not only am I opening it up, I'm gonna tap that darkness with the edge of the clipper blade. The tips, never will I go in just flat. If you go in flat, you're gonna create another line that you're gonna have to get out. When you go in with the tips of the clipper blade, it's like you're tapering and you're feathering out that darkness. As you see right before your eye, that line is disintegrating. And before you know it, the more you work at it and detail at it, you're gonna have a nice fade, a nice feminine fade for a woman. Now, with my zero guard on, I'm using the tips of the clipper blade to smooth out the bottom. This is gonna help get all the loose hairs that you weren't able to get when you were fading up. You fade up and then you work down. Finishing with the other side, now we're gonna create the same effect on this side. But this side, you have to keep in mind that it has to blend with the design in order to make that design pop and jump off of the canvas at the viewer. This is the Andes Fat Blade. It's modified on a cordless NVLI clipper. This is what I'm gonna be using to bring depth and detail to the design. I just used my Slimline Pro LIs to create a small line, which would be the ground zero for the fading. I used the tips of the Andes Fat Blade to grade down from high hair all the way down to the zero, which I created in the middle. This is going to give depth to the leaf and it's going to bring it to life and make it pop. Okay, now that we see that the design is gonna look good by itself with just the client's natural hair, I don't see any harm in adding a little enhancement just on the outside of the leaf. Give it more depth, more life. If she have an engagement for that day, it is perfect. We want it to pop, we want it to look good. We want her, wherever she go, to turn heads and have people asking her, who cut your hair? Now we're gonna go into our design and we're gonna clean up the lines with a little razor work. I like a handheld razor because you can bend it and you can get those curves real sharp, better than any straight razor can get in. Applying light pressure, making sure not to cut the client. You have to make sure to be real gentle and soft on the client's head in this area. You don't want to cause any irritation and bumps. Make sure you go in the same direction that the hair is growing. Most barbers want to get it super clean and they go against the grain, and this causes irritation in ingrown hairs under the skin. Now we come to the portion of the haircut where we're gonna line the client up. We wanna give her a nice, soft, feminine hairline. Some females love the squared look. I like a nice semi-round look in the front. Something's gonna complement their face and the haircut. For the finish to the cut, we're gonna be freehand trimming, blending the top of the style into the bottom. For this, I'll be using my Andes Super ZR tools. This is a detachable clipper. I got my 3-aught blade on it.
Like Paris.